The reveal effect is the name for making invisible text visible on the scene. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do the reveal effect. And we are even going to put a line through it. It will look like it's forming with the line. First, let's create a new composition. A 10 second composition is enough. It can be 9020 by 1080. We will change the background in a moment. I'm going to create a new solid layer. I choose a color and click OK. Now, we are going to write some text on the scene. I take the text tool and let's write some text. You can size this text proportionally to fit our scene. And if you wish, you can use the align panel to center it both vertically and horizontally. Now, we will work on this text. I'm creating a new layer, a solid layer. Select solid and let's assign another color to it. We can move this layer down because the text should be visible now. I'm going to make the text a little bit smaller. Now, we need to draw a line. Make sure that no layers are selected on the scene. Take the pen tool in the toolbox at the top and click somewhere so that it is above the text. As you can see, a new shape layer has been created. Shift click on another point to the right above the text so that there is a line between them. I press the Alt key on the keyboard and click on the fill color. Look, it's going to change here. I'm going to click again and I'm going to click until it's empty. And I'm going to make the stroke right next to it white. We can make a little bit thicker. Let's turn off the properties of the layer and I come to the red layer. I select the selection tool from the toolbox. I lower this solid layer down so that it is in the center of the line. Our goal is this. We want the text to appear as the line descends. So I need to associate the line on the red layer in the background. I select the red layer. Look, there is such an icon here, under parent. This is such a line. I can drag it wherever I want to associate it. I want to associate it with the line, so I drag it over the line and let it go. Now, when I am on the line, I press the letter P of position on the keyboard. When I move the line, we will see that the red layer underneath also moves. I'm moving the text behind the red. Let's set the position so that it is in the center of the text, because in a moment, we will try to make this invisible. I'm moving the text behind the red layer. I'm even painting the red layer black. So when I go to Layer, Solid Settings with the red layer selected, I change it to black. And then I go to the matte column of the black layer. When I click on it, we will choose the second option from the options that pop up. We are going to choose Alpha Inverted Matte. So we'll have the effect we want. Now we can animate. Let's make the text invisible by moving the line up like this. Let's give it a position effect. I'm going to move the timeline forward a little bit and this time I'm going to set the line to be below the text. See, when we check, we will have an effect like this. It is very slow. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more on the second keyframe. We can make it faster, but it is too static. So I select the two keyframes and press F9 on the keyboard. We can make it a little bit softer. But if you want it to look nicer, I select the two keyframes again and open the graph editor. I want it to start fast and end slowly. So this part will go fast and then it will slow down towards the end. Let's test this and see how it looks. I think it looks good. We can do the opposite by turning off the graph editor. For example, your name appeared here. Then we can make it disappear by going back up. How do we do that? I click on this little icon on the left side of position. You adjust the distances between these keyframes according to your own work, of course. I'm just trying to make an example. Now let's see what this looks like. It goes down and it goes up. Our goal was to make a reveal effect, to make the invisible text appear through the line, or to make it look like that. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. If you learned some cool new stuff from today's video, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video.